This is the original frame that came with the car, and it's been cleaned up and spray painted black to be able to just match anything. It'd be mainly covered, but to see anything and just to protect it, it's been spray painted black. Originally, the top would have had all of these bows that will go through. It would have been wood. The wood was rotted and some of the pieces were missing. So we ordered bows. They're synthetic. They came from California Imports, which is CIP1.com. I'll have a link below. But this is synthetic. And this is the front bow that's screwed onto the frame. And then you come back here and there is another bow that will come above the window. The window will sit down here. So this is another synthetic bow from California Imports. And then these back bows, it's three pieces, one, two, three. This is what the top will staple to. And that's also from California Imports, and they're synthetic. You can get wood bows. They're extremely expensive. And so we got these synthetic bows because you won't actually see any of them. There are two more bows, one on each side, one here, and then one on the other side. This is where the back window rolls up. These are the original wood bows that were original to the car. They were the only wood bows that we had. And they were patched up because they were had a few little holes and notches in them, so it had some wood filler and then painted black. So you've got your header bow at the very front, then you've got the bow that goes above the window, then you've got your back bows where it will staple the top to the car, and then you've got your bows on each side of the back of your back glass. So we are going to be going through the process. This is a 1971 Super Beetle, and we'll kind of be doing a step-by-step progression of putting the top on. The top is bought from Chuck's. Okay, now we've got the headliner, which is what we'll show on the inside of the car. We've got it resting inside the car. This is the center mark of the headliner, and then we measured up a center mark, which all the calculations are in his manual. But the center mark of the back bow, staple here, then you staple out to his measurements on each side, and then we'll be moving now to the front of the car. Okay, so after we've attached to the back bow, it came up to this front header bow. And on the driver's side corner, you start and you attach to, you pull it up to this mounting plate. You see there's a little flap here. So we've got this front mounting plate. And then we attach, we first put a staple in here. And then it tells you to repeat on the passenger side. So we attach on the passenger side. And then what we did, it said to staple all the way across. So we put a staple in the center and then stapled out and then stapled this way. So that way it wouldn't bunch up necessarily. And it tells you to pull it taut. Okay, so now we are back at the rear bow that attaches to the car. And what we did is we put more staples in to secure it. And then now we have the webbing straps. You have two of them on that start back here. And in Chuck's manual, he talks about you'll measure from the center out 16.5 inches, and you take the webbing strap and you staple it at that 16.5 inch. So the middle of the strap meets up at that measurement. One thing that we discovered that wasn't said is we first just stapled it down the edge of the strap here, and it kept coming loose from the staples. So we folded it over some so then it would staple into itself to secure it, because otherwise both sides just kept coming loose. We now need to attach them to the wooden or synthetic bow that goes above the window. So the first step is you've got your center mark on the car, and you have to measure from the top of this metal lip up to the top of this wooden bow. And Chuck says that it needs to be exactly 21.5 inches from the top of the metal lip to the top of the wooden bow. So you measure that, get it in place, and then you will staple down. This has got a notched space for the strap to lay flat. You'll staple this down. Then you measure this measurement from the bottom or top of the metal lip to where you've got the top here. And then you transfer that measurement over to this strap. That way they are stapled in equal measurement, and that way your back bow will be exactly level. So all of that is in his manual whenever you order these supplies from him. One, two, three, fourth bow. You take the strap, you wrap it around itself and tuck it under, and then you put a screw into this metal bow. So you'll do that side, then you'll do the next side. So here's the webbing strap. We've connected it to the first bow. It goes through the notch of the second. We skip over the third, and then we screw into this fourth bow. Okay, now we've got one last step to attach these webbing straps. What you do is we've got the one attached to the car, the back wooden bow above the window, and then this next very first metal bow, we have to screw in the webbing strap into this metal bow. So these measurements have to be exact. They have to be between 8 1/8 inch to 8 3/16 inch. It will measure from this top part that sticks out on this wooden bow to the center of this metal bow. So you've got to make sure the measurements meet those specifications, screw it in, and then also have to have the same measurements on the other side. And then your webbing straps, these back two, are then attached. We're getting ready to glue the listings, which are these fabric pieces, to each of the bows. So what we're doing is we're laying down these paper strips to prevent any overspray, to keep it from getting on the rest of the headliner. We're gonna be using this 3M Super 77 multi-purpose adhesive that we picked up at Home Depot. So first we're gonna spray the listing. Next, we need to spray this back wood bow. This is the bow that goes above the window. We'll use a piece of cardboard to help with any overspray. And then whatever upholstery adhesive you get, just read the instructions and it will tell you your bonding time and your drying time. And we've got the garage door open, so you're gonna hear some noise that wasn't in the previous part of the video. Then we're pulling up.
That's probably the only biggest time we get that.
And over to wrap. It says to pull it tight, but then when you read Chuck's manual, he'll give you the exact measurements that you need.
Half inch? That's a little more. This here's close.
And it's gotta be sure to have the same amount all the way across. You want the same amount, or otherwise inside the car it will look like it's sagging or uneven. Okay, and now you'll have to cut into this. Make sure not to cut the actual headliner, but the listing that wraps over, you'll cut it to be able to go around these webbing straps. So then we put clamps on to keep the fabric on while the glue dries. And then we're moving to the foremost bow that has the strap attached to it. We've got one more bow in the front later, but we're gonna go to the foremost that still has the webbing strap. Keep a check on the inside of the car and you'll be able to tell noticeably if there's any type of sag or anything that's uneven, because this is what you're gonna be seeing.
There's a little bit
inside, so this will kind of tell you where it needs to pull and where to measure.
Too much there.
Yeah.
All right, now we are to do the gluing to the foremost metal bow, and that bow actually doesn't have any of the webbing strap attached to it. So we'll do the foremost metal bow And there's another bow in front of that, the synthetic wood bow, but we're not worried about that right now. So we'll do the foremost metal bow, then we'll come back and do the rearmost metal bow, which is the bow right above the wood bow. Okay, so now all of the listings are attached to each bow, except you'll see that this front bow just has the top. We haven't wrapped anything else around this front bow. But each of the metal bows and other wood bows that are on top of the frame have now been wrapped. Okay, after we got each of the bows wrapped with the listing fabric and they're clamped down as they're drying, we then took any of the excess listing fabric in case it was hanging down here or if it was laying over the headliner, then we trimmed it. So you can tell we trimmed here and then we trimmed here as well so that it didn't just lay on top of the headliner and that way you wouldn't see anything through the inside. And then the last step is on this back wooden bow. This is the bow that is right above where the window will go. We then stapled on the underneath to secure it. Here is the inside of the headliner once it is attached to all of the bows. This one is an off-white, showing up a little bit yellow here, but so this is where the back glass will go. This is the back of the car. We don't have all of the carpet or the back seat in yet, but this is some insulation that we've used since the engine is in the back and it will help with some of the heat that would come through the engine compartment. So this is the headliner so far. We're now attaching the rubber to the back window metal frame. You could have a wood frame, but we have a metal frame. The inside diameter of the frame has to measure between 11 and 11 and a half inches, and Chuck's manual will explain the importance of that. And it also will explain how you'll have to measure to screw everything in. So we did the measurements as instructed, and we're using a combination of screws and glue to connect the rubber to the actual frame. We've now installed the metal frame, which is what we have, is a metal one, with the rubber is what you see here. And so we've measured, here's the center mark that we keep working on, and we've measured from the top of this metal lip up to the top of this rubber, which is called the tacking strip, and it's got to be exactly 3.5 inches. And again, the manual will explain all of this. And so we've tacked the webbing strip on the side over here, and then we tacked the webbing strip over here to keep the frame in place. On these back panels, it already has the foam inserts in them. It's two pieces of fabric that are sewn together around these foam pads. They go around the back window. So they need the foam padding. There needs to be about an inch from the edge of the padding to the inside of this window, inside the tack strip. So like this rubber piece, where it is the side of the window, there needs to be about an inch from there to the foam padding. And then we'll begin stapling down here onto this bottom bow that's inside the car that everything else has been stapled to. We'll staple here. Then we'll staple up top inside the wooden bow that's above the window. And we'll be sure to staple inside instead of on top because the staples would show through the top. And then we'll staple around the window into that strip. Okay, so now here are the two different pads. This one has been trimmed. This one still has some stapling that needs to be done, and then it will get trimmed. So we've trimmed up around the window, trimmed up, and then we've trimmed down here at the car, the metal lip, and then up here, because you'll have excess fabric that will come all around, as you can see here. So we've got this excess will need to be cut, this will all need to be cut, and then this will need to be cut, which we've already trimmed it to come around the webbing strap to make it easier for to staple. And the staples will go back here, but all of this will be trimmed off after you complete all of your staples. So here's a before, and then here's the after, what it will look like. And there they are with both sides cut. and stapled down. Voila. Okay, now we've placed the pad wrap on top of the car, and you'll see that it's this white material connected to vinyl and to black cloth. And it's got to be centered on the car, and also the seams have to be facing up. So you'll see here the seams where it's sewn together, and here this needs to face up because eventually this will be covered, you won't see it, and you want it to look nicer on the underneath. So seams up, centered on the car. And the first step, you've got your wood header bow, or synthetic in our case, that goes above the window. And so we're gonna take it and we're gonna staple it to the back, just like where these staples are, to the back of this wooden bow to secure it. We've now stapled it down to that back bow that's above the window. If you have any excess fabric, you can trim it. We didn't really have any excess, but your top may come with a bit more of a hang down in the back. So now we'll move to the front. Now we're moving to this front bow, which is this black bow that you see here. And so what we have to do is we have to lift the top and place half inch shims between the top, which is this where this bow is, and between the car above the windshield. Okay, so when we fold this back, we see where the headliner was stapled on towards the beginning of the process. So what we'll do is we'll apply glue to the back part of this front headliner bow, and then we will pull this entire lining taut as possible and push it down against the glue, and then we will put in staples about where these staples are. So now we've stapled down that fabric on the pad liner, and then we cut the excess white fabric so it wasn't hanging down. And so now we're laying the pad into place. We have the foam centered on the car, and we folded it back and have started gluing. We'll glue one part, get it flattened out, and then move to the next. You want it to be completely flat without any bumps so that it will look nice under your top. Now we've got the pad glued down across the car, and the next step is to take these black linen pieces that are on the pad lining, and we will spray glue on the foam pad and then lay the black linen pieces on top. We'll do one side before we move on to the next, but it's very important that these linen pieces are perfectly straight, have no creases or wrinkles, because again, it will show through to your cover. We've now glued down one side of this fabric onto the foam, made sure that we got out any wrinkles or creases. So then you move to the back, and we're stapling it to this back bow again that's above the window. So it's going to be stapled in here. You don't want to staple on top because you would see it. So we're going to staple to the side, and then we'll trim any of the excess fabric. Now you move to the front of the car and you see this excess fabric. So what we're gonna do, we're putting down a paper strip, not to get any overspray, but you have to spray the black linen fabric. And what we'll do is we'll then push it down onto this front wooden bow, making sure it's pulled tight with no wrinkles. We now have both flaps glued to the foam, so we'll move to the back bow above the window and staple, then we'll move to the front and glue to the front bow, and then after it dries, we will trim this excess fabric, and you can go ahead and trim the excess fabric that's been stapled to the back. Now the back flaps are stapled down and trimmed. Here's the front bow with the flaps glued down and trimmed. The last step in the saga of the padding and the pad lining is, after you've got it glued down and trimmed, put one staple on each side into the wooden bow. It's late, we're tired. We're on day two of installation. And so now we're coming to putting all of the cables in place. I'll show you the cables and kind of run you through it, but my suggestion is that you can see where we run them, but I'm not gonna give you any measurements. You just need to follow your manufacturer's instructions on installation because it's so specific and it's so important. So just follow your instructions on where all your cables should run and how to hook up your vinyl top to the rest of the frame and the other parts of the top. You'll attach the first cable to the spring that is inside the frame and follow your manufacturer's instructions for exactly how that should be done. Okay, now we're laying the vinyl top on the very top of everything else. You'll then follow your manufacturer's instructions for how to thread this wire through the top, which will go all the way back through here. If you have a string like our vinyl top has that's attached, instead of tying it, which might be a little bit harder to run through the top, you could do like we did and take the string and tape it onto your wire, and then that makes it a little easier to thread through your vinyl. So now we've taken a second cable. It's running through an existing hole that's already in the top. We had to widen our hole just a bit for this to pass through, and we've got a bolt on there just holding it in place so it doesn't come out. But it's gonna come through here and it's gonna run through a hole that was already in the vinyl top and run across to the other side where it does the same. We now have the top halfway opened, and the first cable that we had attached to a spring in the frame and then we ran down, we're taking that to, this is the rear quarter facing, and we're going to screw it, attach it to a screw on the back side. We're gonna put a foam piece on this front header bow, and our reason is whenever you look at the liner, you can see through, like this is a hole notched out for you to screw the bow to the frame. And there's just like little things that we don't want to show through the actual vinyl top. So we're gonna put this foam to help pad it. When you order a kit, it may come with foam, it may not. Ours didn't, so we got this. And you could go to a fabric store and get it, or an upholstery store. But we're gonna go ahead and glue that down, and then we'll trim it to the size that we need after it's glued down. We raised the top up about halfway so that we could pull the vinyl cover over this front bow and over the padding. And then you're gonna make your first cuts into the vinyl. So just take a deep breath. We cut out a notch for the pin and then a notch here where it hooks into the top. So we'll do that on each side and make sure that your top is lined up and centered, and then make the cuts. It's easier to work with the top when you lift it a bit. So we're needing to have the beading that's here on the top meet with the bottom edge of that front header bow. So we've lifted it to be able to pull it, and then you can notch a bigger hole if you need to. We've now put a staple on each side to hold it in place. We've now stapled it into place on the underneath of the front bow. We've now got this flap that what we'll do is it's gonna be brought down and glued onto the frame. So you've gotta make sure that this beading matches up with the bottom of the frame so it's flush, and that your corners on each side are fitting well. So we'll wrap that around and we'll glue. We've glued down this flap, and then we've got some clamps on the inside to help keep it in place as it dries. Next, we'll take this flap over the quarter panel and you'll wrap it so that the beading meets up here. So you'll pull it tight. We've got the top a little less than halfway up. And then we've got an existing hole right here that was already in the car, and we're gonna screw the top have to put a hole in the vinyl top and screw through this existing hole. Here's a side we've already done. We pulled the vinyl top over this quarter panel and pulled it taut so that the beading met up. And then we screwed through the vinyl into that existing hole. We now got the cable. It's at the back, and earlier in the video we ran it through the car where there was an existing hole. And so you're going to run it through a little notch and loosely attach a nut on each side of the cable. And here's a close-up. So we have where we ran it through the car, and then there is where you will bolt it through. With the top half raised, we're now going to be pulling this back cable down, and you'll follow your instructions that your manufacturer gives you on how to get the cable hidden. Now, to get this cable to disappear underneath the top, the screws that we showed you just a little bit earlier that are hidden on each side back in here, we will tighten little by little on each side so that it tightens evenly on each side, and this cable will eventually tuck up under here and you won't see it. Well, folks, what you see here is a snapped cable. We had just started adjusting, had barely given it much of a turn, and it still would have had a lot more to go. So we're not sure what caused it. It didn't get caught on anything in the car. It hadn't been pulled tight. I mean, it looked the same as what we had shown. It hadn't gotten under the lip anymore. So yeah, I don't know, things happen. We called Chuck's and described to him what happened. And the guy that we talked to there suggested that this extra material that's under the vinyl, that we trim this to where there's only about half an inch left. He said sometimes that material can get caught on the lip and make it difficult for this cable to go where it needs. We got the replacement cable in the mail today, and we've got it screwed back into inside the car, and we now have got it positioned where it comes under. This is where the metal lip is, so we've got it pulled under this metal lip, and the suggestion we were given was to tap it into place before we start doing any of the tightening inside the car. We've been working that cable underneath that lip and then getting ready to start tightening on each side to create some more tension. We've been working the cable under, and then we'll go and little by little tighten on each side, then come and work it under some more and tighten on each side, and just keep repeating the process so that you gently are working it in instead of just tightening it and having the risk of it snapping. Now we're going to take the canvas flap and wrap it around this quarter facing, which is the original wood that we have. And what we did first is we put one staple to set it into place. And you may have to trim some excess fabric if needed. And then we drilled an 1/8 inch hole and then put this screw in by hand. Then we stapled all the way up, and we did it in line with where the rubber will go. Now we're at the point that we're supposed to pull the top all the way closed into the watertight position, but it basically is not budging much past this point. It is pretty much drum tight. It will be, especially when it's closed. So what we did is we loosened the cable just a tiny bit more, and we're going to put it out in the sun tomorrow. We had to work inside today because of rain, so tomorrow we'll put it out in the sun for a couple hours to see if it stretches and loosens the vinyl top a bit to be able to get it closed in the watertight position. We put the top out this morning, and so we've had the car and the top sitting out in the sun about 6.5 hours. Which we have kind of a cloudy, overcast, cooler day, so not quite as warm or sunny as we'd like, but it did help limber up the vinyl enough for us to close it. It was still pretty tight to close, and then we wound up opening it back up to make sure that that cable was in there a little bit better, and then we've closed it back up again. We've made a cut in the center of the window frame, 10 inches long. This is going to help you relieve the tension to start stapling around the inside diameter of the window frame. As we staple around, we make cuts to be able to get enough relief to be able to pull it down to the frame. So we just are going slowly, making our cut slowly, cutting away little by little. These are the scissors that we've been using to cut everything on the convertible top, and we picked these up at Home Depot. I just used this razor to cut all along up to the staples so that you've got the window frame exposed. We're applying glue to the headliner to get ready to cut and fold it over the frame. Cut out the center of the headliner and then made some cuts to help with the tension. So now you're going to get ready to glue and staple to the frame. I'm now inside of the car, and what I'm doing is pulling it taut to the outside while he staples, so that way there's not going to be any slack or any type of ripples, and that way you'll get a nice tight headliner on the inside. And just slowly work your way around, and there you go. I'm now using scissors to go around and to trim all of the excess headliner around the outside. We're attaching the headliner to the wood quarter facings with a screw. We're attaching the bottom of the headliner to a metal tab that is in the car, and it will help pull out any wrinkles. Now we're going to attach these front flaps to the metal frame. We're attaching the assist straps to the frame. We have the back ready to put the back glass in, and we're going to be installing the original back glass, which is pretty neat. We're going to start putting on the rubber pieces, and so first we'll put the piece that goes on this back quarter piece. So here's a piece of rubber, inside is a metal piece, and that will be what screws onto the wood piece, and then we will keep screwing on into the metal frame, and so it will go all the way there. Same on the other side. I finished the rubber on both sides that goes all the way up around the windows, and then there's a piece of rubber that goes here right under the top. You'll put your sun visors back on if you've taken those off, and then this plastic was originally, you can see that it was broken, so we filled it in with some epoxy and then we spray painted it black. It was originally white, but it had yellowed quite a bit. So we thought the black looked better and just kind of helped hide all the little things that had broken on it. And then screwed it into place. On the inside, we carpeted back here in the storage compartment and just tacked that down over the headliner. The back glass can be a pain to install, so if you have issues with it or just feel like you really can't do it yourself, you can have someone do it at a glass shop, or you can check at an upholstery shop that installs convertible tops, and they'll be able to install the back glass for you.